Take three. So my phone decides we need to act up as I was recording the video, because it automatically changed the saving location from my SD card to my phone, which doesn't really have any space on it. So the phone crashed, and about like 7 minutes of video ended up getting lost. But that's cool. I wasn't really that deep in what I was trying to say anyway. But regardless of the fact, first and foremost, let me just apologize for not being able to do this on my laptop with the visuals and everything how I would like to do it. Some of you know that one of the factors that plays into that is that the elements are pretty much against me. You know, I have noisy family members that it just seems like clockwork. Like they just want to just be disturbing to me. It seems like any time before I'm recording, literally before I'm recording anything, it's like everything is like quiet and, you know, nobody's saying anything, nobody's doing nothing. But the split second I hit the record button, it's like doors are slamming, people start visiting out of nowhere, bringing their noisy kids over, somebody just starts saying out of no damn where, somebody's talking loud, somebody's yelling, and it's just like, the elements are just against me. So I have to come somewhere like in the garage to try to even remotely get some type of serenity to where I'm not getting distracted by all those things, because I can't speak for anybody else, but me, when anytime I'm recording a video, I know that one, those distractions, they distract the viewer from what's being said, and two, it distracts me, the person that's trying to explain whatever it is the topic is, that it constantly throws me off because I need silence in order to focus. Like, I need to focus on what it is that I'm talking about. And oftentimes, I don't get that focus because all this extra stuff, all the extra nonsense is going on. So it does throw you off for a time. Regardless of that, another factor that played into me doing this was that while I was on my laptop, I was trying to check for audio issues before I officially started recording the video, and I didn't get around to actually hitting the record button to do what I wanted to. So what happened was I ended up the laptop ended up crashing, so I couldn't get the video to record anyway, because as I was checking the audio on my laptop, the screen just turned black and it just crashed regardless. So that right there was a factor that played into me doing this as well. So let me just say thank you to everybody who has been supporting me on this channel. Last time I checked, I had like 2,166 subscribers. I think I lost 3 last time I checked before I came out here. So we had 2,163 official. And, yeah, man, I can't, you know, to somebody like me, like, I never forget, you know, my mecca. Like, I never forget my genesis. I never forget where things started. You know, when I first started this channel back in 2006, whether it was June or July, I think it was June 2006, I can't remember the exact day, but it was around June and July 2006, and the channel didn't really have it such a direction. At the time, I was just trying to upload any little cool video that I had. I was just happy just to upload something like that was mine on YouTube. So I was playing S4E and Grand Chase for those of you who remember that game. But those games, you know, I was uploading video footage of that. That was one of the first videos that I uploaded. S4E was like the first video I uploaded. It was just like a random match. And then I started playing Grand Chase more often. Then I started uploading combo videos of, you know, various characters on Grand Chase. And then after a while, my attention switched because even though I was gaining a little bit of subscribers from those videos, I wanted my channel to have a sense of direction that I could hone in on. And one of those things that I noticed was that, you know, I like Nintendo DS games. That's, at the time, I loved Nintendo DS games, and I still do, even though I haven't had an opportunity I began to notice that anytime I went to Nintendo DS playthroughs on YouTube, the people who were uploading those videos, they never uploaded the full playthrough. It was just like one random gameplay video of the game, and they didn't follow up with anything else after that. It was just like one just quick gameplay video, and then it was just it. The only full playthroughs people were actually doing, if any, were some Pokemon game, and that was like the extent of it. Nobody did a full playthrough of any other Nintendo DS game at the time. Because I looked, I played several Nintendo DS games, and I couldn't find no help. Not that I really needed it, but I was just curious to see how other people, you know, beat certain sections of the games that I was playing. And I couldn't get any, so I couldn't see any content. So I figured, well, since nobody else is doing it, I'll do it. You know, let me get the video game playthroughs going for Nintendo DS, and that was my focus for a time. And then I noticed that my subscriber count shot up from like 18 to like 53, and over time it became like 100, and you know, it just started going up from there, because I actually had like a real focus for the channel, and I was happy with that. And of course, over time, I wanted to do, you know, Nintendo DS was beginning to be unsupported, and I moved on to 3DS, but I didn't have any way to direct capture it like I was doing with Nintendo DS. So I think the last Nintendo 3DS game I played, well, Nintendo DS / Nintendo 3DS game I played, was Big Project Cross Zone. I think that was it. No, I think it was Shimagami Tensei. I don't know if it was Devil Survivor or something. I think it was Devil Survivor. I'm 100% sure. But it was that and Project Cross Zone, the two games that I did full playthroughs of while I had Nintendo 3DS for the time. This was back when I was still in Louisiana before I left. So I was done back in like 2013, 2014. Yeah, I had full play in those games. I was making a transition to direct capture to the console that I had at the time, which was the PS3. You know, when I started doing console games before then, I just had like a camera set up. It was a very guerrilla style recording where I would have the video set up and I would just, you know, do things like that. And there were some funny moments, like when I was playing, I can't remember what game I was playing, and the power went out. You know, I want to say it was the Beyond Two Souls demo at the time. This was before Beyond Two Souls came out as an official game, as a full-length game. They had the demo out for it. I played it, and as I was playing, the power just cut off and it went out. The game went out. So it's like that, you know, you miss when you have certain games, you know. But the recording has definitely gotten better. But at that time, you know, I was in my focus to try to make a transition to console games. Because Grand Theft Auto 5 was coming out, and I really wanted to play that. And I didn't really get a chance to do the capture until, let's say, 2010, a few years later. So, to have some time to actually practice and test out different things and what it was I was doing. You know, I was even doing like some deck profiles. I was reviving old designs, old builds, old archetypes with this series I had called Retro Modernization. And it was a fun time. Once doing that was shut down, all that kind of just went with it. Because I didn't have a place to practice and keep up with the actual game. So I didn't have cards. I didn't want to actually buy cards. Because at the time, I didn't have any real time to compete or to hold up. There wasn't a local scene out there for you, you know, so I just left alone. Doing that work was really my only chance to actually get. That was my closest thing to a hands-on experience with the cards. So anything new that came out, I would go to doing that work, practicing, and then after a while, just doing it would die. Tried UPS Play cards, and I intended to do more Yu-Gi-Oh content on there, but it was just like, I just, at that time, my passion for the game was already gone. I couldn't even get it back. It was like, once it was gone. Every now and then, I jump on Doom Book and I try to see what's going on, and I'm so lost at this point, where it's just like, I don't even care. They got all these new things got out, and I'm just like, I'm good. So, looking back at everything, people look at my 2,163 subscribers and say, oh man, that's nice, that's awesome, they know you're going to earn. What they're not understanding is that all of that is mixed, you know, the different things that I was telling you about me, the different things I was trying out on this channel, from Yu-Gi-Oh content to TLDS playthrough videos to console playthroughs, I was developing a fan base for each of those things. So when certain things stopped, I was even doing like the taste test videos and things like that, the different loves. You know, there was quite a few things going on. I mean, so the channel was mixed in with like a lot of stuff. The channel was mixed in with a lot of things. And I just, you know, I was pulling fans in from different things I was doing to the point where when I stopped doing them, people were still coming back to the channel to look for any new content for that, for those certain things that I wasn't doing. And when they didn't get it, they just stopped coming. So people see that 2,163, even though I'm proud to have that, it's still, it's not like a focused subscriber base. You know what I mean? It's not a focused subscriber base. It's very mixed. It's very influenced from different things that I was doing. It's that's not for me doing what I'm doing now. Several factors is playing into the decision I made. This isn't something that I just thought about doing tonight. This isn't something that I, you know, just went to sleep and woke up and said I was going to do this. But for people who know me and watch my content consistently, you guys know this has been weighing heavy on me for years. You know, I made the notion, or I threw out the notion that I was going to do this years ago. And I just haven't followed through with it because I thought maybe I could do something to try to, you know, get back on track or do something with the channel that could help put it in a better space. But right now I'm just realizing that it's too much going on. Like, the content is too convoluted. It's too mixed. There isn't a focused agenda with the channel. It's just like, I'm trying to do is just too much, and I think people that come to this channel, they get overwhelmed and they just stop coming to view the content that I'm doing. They just get overwhelmed with everything that's on here, to where even if I make a video trying to get a response out of people, out of the 2,163 people that I have, I'm probably like, I'll be lucky if I get like one comment, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's definitely not an interactive subscriber base. When you look at your subscribers on YouTube, you're supposed to look at those as potential views. Now, realistically, you know not all 2,000 people are going to subscribe to balls and things. They probably waiting for like specific things. They're just not interested in the challenge anymore. So he ended up leaving and not coming back. So looking at that, now I'm trying to make this transition and I'm trying to deal with World Warriors Collective, which is my clothing brand that I'm trying to work, which originally was a Facebook group to where I was trying to unify gamers from all over the world. I'm trying to turn that into an esports team with a clothing line that supports it, as well as other gamers all around. You know, you guys can check out those things. The links are in the description. Use discount code WORLD10 to get 10% off your total purchase. By the way, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. It's kind of backwards because of the camera, but it says, "I don't sweat, I give skills," you know. And I have these in gym tanks as well. So you guys check that out. And I have many more things. Check out the Global Collective collection where I have countries with the World Warriors Collective logo on it. But with that being said, I think this channel is, I don't think this channel is coming to me. I'm letting you know that this channel, it's been good to me, it's been good for me. But because of everything that's happening, it's just like I can't. Let me put it like this. Let's say somebody all their life, they were growing their hair out. Now, in the process of them growing their hair out, you know, they combed their hair, they picked it out, you know, all that stuff. You know, they were taking care, but in the process, they ended up developing scabs in their hair or scratches or anything like that. No, I'm not talking about me, I'm good. But no, somebody develops scabs and things like that. And the only way for those scabs to heal properly is that they have to cut off all their hair that they spent years and years in growing. And let the scabs heal. And then their hair is going to grow back healthier. They're going to have a healthier scalp and things like that. But metaphorically, that's this channel. The channel has been through a lot. And I think because of what it's been through, a lot of the majority of people are like staying away from the channel because they don't find it interesting anymore. And mainly because I don't find it interesting anymore. Only because I can't get the content out the way I would like to. And anytime I do it, it's like I can't even get a decent response from people. And I don't necessarily blame you, but I kind of blame myself for something like this. We all got to take our share of blame. There's a lot of things that we need to support. But I blame myself for not hearing it because I kind of struck my mind at the time. And I didn't do it. You know, me being younger at the time, I didn't really know how to go about doing it. So I missed an opportunity to really blow the channel up. So or make something big out of it. But give the channel a clear focus, people are going to come to the channel and subscribe to the channel for that which I'm focusing on, instead of them just coming here and they finding out, oh, I got 17 different things going on, I have 17 different things going on the channel, and it's just like, okay, do I click on it? It's basically like going to a restaurant and they got this large ass menu and you just gotta sit there and you scan it. Eventually you're gonna get tired before you even order anything, and you're gonna get up and you're gonna leave. So, you know, it's really one of those things. You know, it's like a restaurant has like Jamaican food, they got a Jamaican side to their menu, they got an American side to their menu, they have an Italian side to, you know, man, you don't know what you're dealing with. You know, so you ended up just leaving because you get overwhelmed by everything. And that's basically what's happening on this channel. I think 2,163 subscribers, they get overwhelmed by what they're seeing on the channel, from the vlogs to the Yu-Gi-Oh! Content that I'm no longer doing. I still get people coming to this channel looking at my Yu-Gi-Oh! Content, not even knowing that I stopped doing that years ago. People can still come back from Nintendo DS playthroughs, which is good. You know, I'm glad. You know, but it's like nobody's caught up to what I'm currently doing because everybody's still stuck to the past. So what I'm doing is now is that this channel, it's coming to an end. It's coming to an end for good reason. One, because, again, metaphorically speaking, I need to shave all that hair off the head, and I need to let the scabs heal and just basically just start over. I need to start over. You know, I got basically, I just need a fresh start, and I can't do that with this channel. You know, all the content that is on this channel, it's going to remain on here. You know, but the new channel, which I'm still fixing up and things like that, I'm going to announce it probably at the end of this week or sometime next week. Probably before this week is over, probably. Because I like to work fast, I don't really like to work slow. Most importantly, I'm working on getting that, you know, up and running. The new focus of that channel is going to be to get the clothing line sold, to get the clothing line, the shirts, the leggings, the hoodies, the stickers, the coffee mugs, the t-shirts, but basically all the merch. I wanted that to be like one of the main focal points because I think it's good merchandise and it represents us that play video games regardless of what country you come from. There's something for you there. And I'm just aiming to get the message of unity out there regardless of what country you come from. Regardless of which language you speak, we all speak that language in a joystick. You understand what I'm saying? We all speak that language of skill and competitive nature and friendly competition. We all speak that. So that's what my clothing line is, the cornerstone. That's the foundation of this clothing line in the esports team, is to unify people regardless of what country you come from through video games. Definitely the focus is going to be still video game playthroughs, but it won't be convoluted with all this other stuff that's going on. I'm going to finish up whatever few playthroughs I do have on this channel, but just know that once those obligations are done, this channel is coming to an end. This channel is finished. So I'm going to finish up Absolver. I'm going to finish up any other online matches I have, any playthroughs of the playlist that I have. Just finish up any last little bit of obligations that I have. And then we're going to move on to the next channel. So I don't know if you'll be able to find it because I don't know if YouTube allows it to be searched. The name of the channel is World Warriors Collective. The same way that it's spelled for the clothing line, the same way that it's spelled on the shirts, that's the name of the channel. World Warriors Collective. WORLD. We'll be right back. will be doing live streams and all that on that channel. So just let you guys know. Go over there and subscribe to it. But I have the link to that channel in this video description. That way, in case you can't search it, at least you'll be able to click the link and go straight to there and subscribe ahead of time. So that's basically it. Thank you guys for supporting me on the EDS Play 101. But this channel was on its last leg, so let's have the fun that we're gonna have with this channel, and then let's move on to bigger and better things. So, don't feel sad, don't feel like apologizing to me because the channel's coming to an end. But I need a fresh start, a new foundation in order to make a success out of what I'm trying to do. And World Warriors Collective is basically what I'm gonna be focusing on. Support the Warriors Collective.